Hello everyone and welcome back to the Key Productive YouTube channel. On today's feature, I'm going to be diving into 5 applications I'm excited for in 2021. This is a list with some productivity mentions, but also a few others just outside the spectrum of productivity. And they're all in my opinion, so hopefully they help you. And I'll include all the link in the description below. So before we begin, make sure to check out the Keep Focus community. It's a new project we've launched and we're super excited to be adding some events to it very soon. So do check out the link in the description. So first on my list is an app called Clay, and this is a personal CRM tool that's designed more for individuals who are looking to manage their network. It's really interesting, the application. I'm actually testing it out in sort of its private beta at the moment. It's quite expensive, but the concept of it's quite cool, where you connect it to, say, your LinkedIn and your email contact, and basically it brings up your network, but allows you to go a bit deeper with them by adding actions, taking notes for each person, and being able to see specific updates. It's sort of like a really condensed LinkedIn that allows you to keep fresh and updated with each of the contacts. I think the most exciting thing about this application is that there are these applications that are like highly developed for specific areas, and I think this is going to be a massive trend in 2021. We've seen it with Superhuman, who took email and really beautified it, or beautified it, something like that. But basically, I reckon more companies will start to do that, take a small segment of a productivity application and just make it a really well produced experience with a higher price to it. And Clay is one of those applications that does that. And it could be quite interesting for those folks in the future who are looking for a personal CRM, but don't necessarily want to invest in a really highly priced one for the enterprise plans. So Clay, I'm keeping an eye out. It's a very gorgeous and well-designed application, and I'm sure it'll be coming soon in 2021. Next up is Daybridge. This is an app that I have been checking out for a while. It's very interesting the way that it's set up. So the reason why I'm sort of excited about this is because it's giving me sunrise vibes. Although I think definitely Woven at the moment is the new sunrise. It's a really well put together application, but I think this will re-change the way that the calendar market is positioning itself now. So what's interesting about Daybridge is it's bringing together lots of different formats of your calendar. For example, your daily routine, but also adding stuff that other people have invited you to, and travel plans, connecting to apps that are just outside the calendar ecosystem to help you make a calendar that's very smart and intuitive and really almost like a personal assistant more than it is a calendar application. I really like the design as well. It seems to be really well put together, and I'm super interested because the developers are working very hard behind this at the moment. I'd recommend checking them out on Twitter because this is where they're sharing updates, regular news about what's happening, but they've definitely got some good investment behind them. I think this could potentially be the next big calendar application of the future. Number 3 is Obsidian. Now this, the reason why I'm sort of talking about this is because whilst this is out in beta at the moment, it's actually super well put together. And I think it's definitely, especially in this bi-directional linking world that we're about to be living in, Rome is getting a lot of attention. But I think Obsidian is that sort of like really underplayed competitor that in the future will make a lot more sense. For example, they're adding iOS and I believe iPad and Android applications soon. They said mobile. I assume it will be that in the future, which is a huge leap forward, especially for, you know, what they're doing, and especially the fact that it's free. Obviously, it's from the creators of Dynalist, so you've got knowledge that it's from a good developer who've put together a good app in the past, and it's sort of like Dynalist 2.0 to some extent. But I'm really excited for when they actually release in 1.0 in their public facing launch, which will be really exciting because I think they'll start to sort of put it together for the basic user to understand. I feel like it's a lot easier to understand than, say, Rome, if you're someone that's so new to bi-directional links. So number 4 is ReadWise. Now, ReadWise is an app that I've been using for my Kindle and my notes when I'm taking Kindle highlights. But I really like the way that the application sort of brings up, well, you know, all of the highlights, but in this sort of like spaced repetition methodology. I really like that. You have 10 daily highlights, which you can go into the app and you can review each day. And it helps to build your learning. I really like that concept. But I really like the way that they externally help other people follow your highlights as well. That's part of the premium feature, but I think it's a pretty good tool to have. So I think ReadWise next year will continue to add more features and make it more exciting to read, even though it is quite exciting already to read. Number 5, this is an app that I've talked about over the years. We've talked about TimePage, Flow, and Actions, which are all basically Moleskine Studio apps. Now, I'm excited for Moleskine Studio in 2021, mainly because If they continue the rate that they've been going and adding new applications and building really well put together ones, I think that they will potentially position themselves as the iOS productivity suite of apps that a lot of people jump on board in and pay the like one-off subscription to have all of their apps under the same roof. And for a lot of people, having a suite of apps under the same developer is something that they like because it's under the same roof, all your data is under the same roof, but also the fact that it's built well if the developer is a good developer. For example, Zenkit is one that is developing like lots of different apps under one roof and they're continuing to add to that suite. Todoist is sort of one that is going to be doing that in the future. They've talked quite widely about note-taking application, adding that to their suite and having, you know, Todoist, Twist and Noticed. Let's call it Noticed. So I think that it's quite interesting what Moleskine Studio are doing, especially because they put such well put together iOS applications. And I'm sure they'll be looking in Android as well in the future. Anyway, folks, those are the five apps that I'm excited for in 2021. Let's go through them. Clay, Daybridge, Obsidian, and ReadWise and Moleskine Studio. They're five. I'll probably dive into them a little bit deeper and maybe share a few of my opinions on other apps, but hopefully sort of give you an idea of what I'm thinking is going to be hot in 2021. Anyway, folks, I hope you enjoyed today's video. Please do make sure you hit subscribe and I'll talk to you all in a future video here on Keep Productive. Cheerio, folks.